This is Daily Blast Live. We're talking about what you're talking about.
Get real.
You all ready for this? Mm-hmm. Dun, 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 dun.
No.
Nope.
Y'all, just stop. This is a sham.
Welcome to DBL. Happy Monday and happy President's Day, Tori.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you.
Do you celebrate this like it's your birthday?
I wake up early. No, I'm kidding. I don't.
Why don't we just move this day, seriously, back 2 weeks?
You know what I mean? Super Bowl?
If it lands on the day after the Super Bowl,
you could still call it President's Day.
That's right, because no one's really celebrating. But a lot of people are off work today. But I guess I would still be complaining because we're here.
Yeah, what's up with that? What's up? I don't get it. It's like my entire professional life, I'm always at work when nobody else is.
It's very frustrating.
Then we don't even know why y'all at home. Yeah, I mean, well, now y'all should be home. It's night.
But see, you have to understand there's levels to these holidays. There's some, the federal ones, everybody's off. But there's some where it's like, if you choose to celebrate it, good for you. You know, some of them are mostly for teachers.
I'm telling you, if a president seriously put this in his campaign,
I just say make the day for voting. Let it that be. Oh,
that is a great, that's great point. Great point.
That's getting too technical.
Okay.
All right.
Okay,
so. Let's get to it, guys. Courtney Cox is opening up about getting injections in her face. So speaking to the Sunday Times, Courtney said she tried looking younger for years, but later realized that she started looking strange from the injections and other things she did to her face. Courtney realized people were talking about the dramatic change in her face, AKA talking bleep about her behind her back, and that led to her to stop. So what do you guys think about, you know, we're all getting a little older, there's no hiding that fact. What do you guys think about injections, fillers, or is there a difference in all this stuff?
I'm of the school of thought to not do anything until it's necessary to do something.
You're looking fine.
I always want to hear this wonderful human speak, Erica. You're not.
Yeah.
We're not sure if you're from here. Honest, if you found out Erica's from, you'd be like, okay, well, that makes sense now.
What's that planet from Avatar? She's from there.
You really just like, you're just a beautiful human. But I do think this, and I don't want to cut you off. I will say this. I do think it's hard for us normies to compete.
I mean,
because if you're going on auditions and you look and you're like, man, that person's 9 years younger than me and it shows, and you're in this business, you're going to want to do something. Erica, you can speak. You're just beautiful.
Sorry. Al, seriously. Okay.
You are gorgeous. Hey, Tori, welcome to the show.
We're talking, and I'm like, what's going on? What's happening to me? I'm a normie. Go ahead.
No, Tori, seriously, as a woman, so how do you feel?
I just got Botox, and I want to let everyone know I'm just as transparent as an open book. And I got it because I could see the two lines right here when my face was at rest. And I don't know, it bothered me. And it wasn't that expensive. It was about $36. I got two little things here. And as
$36?
Yeah.
You got Groupon injections?
You sound like it.
I did it.
She got that done into my car.
I got very little, but it made my confidence go up because now when I'm resting face, you don't see it.
But don't you think that's how everybody starts? I don't think everybody goes crazy the first time.
It's like, exactly. It's like a little taste of your Doritos Cool Ranch and then the whole bag's in your hair. You know, or I'm talking about anyone else? Okay. No. Yeah. And she, and she did go too far and we all called her, you know, we all said something and
I didn't.
Well,
I would never shame a woman. You did.
I did.
But you don't go too far until you go too far.
Right? That's right.
That's the thing.
But that's the problem. It's like, she really didn't need what she got. Right. And I think we have so many young women who do not need these things, but they're doing it because everybody else is doing it, and they look, it's aging them.
Mm-hmm. It looks
much
weird.
Faster. So I'm like, it's okay. I mean, I really thought when I was 16, I was like, I want to look older. And I did all these things. I cut my hair off, and I would wear makeup, and I do all of these things. And it turns out I'm 41 years old, and that's just the way I'm supposed to look. I'm supposed to look like a round face. Like, that's just it. It's not going to, it ages differently. So I think you just embrace who you are and where you are.
Yeah, well, I'm a normie, so I guess I don't know.
I am too, but I mean, Erica, can you embrace that after you've like not gotten picked for your 10th audition? And it's like, that never happened 10 years before.
But see, here's the thing though. Stop trying to be a cheap version of something else, because the truth is, you didn't get that audition because that part wasn't for you. There is going to be that something for you, but you try to start doing all these things to manipulate yourself to look like a broke down version of somebody else, No, you're not going to get it because it wasn't for you. It was for the aging of your graceful, beautiful face. Maybe it was for your now gray hair. There's all of these different things that are going to come your way, but everybody's always trying to chase this other thing.
Mm. Embrace it. Embrace it.
My goal is to look like a broke down Michael B. Jordan. That's on my.
I think. That's I mean, my, if it's possible, I would like that as well. I'll take that too. All right, guys. Kim Kardashian is giving us a sneak peek inside her home. Speaking to Vogue, Kim defended her decision to style her home in cream and white tones. Let's watch.
Everything in my house is really minimal. I find that there's so much chaos out in the world that when I come home, I want it to be just really quiet and I want everything to feel calming. In the main house, I really like the calmness. And shockingly, Four Kids hasn't messed up my cream house.
That's because someone cleans up after. All right. Kim also took the opportunity to show off her daughter North's painting, calling her a really good artist. Wow, that is good.
That is good.
That's her emo pic. I looked into this. She also went out to the garage and showed her matching cars. So she got matching cars to her matching gray cream house, which is a level of like baller I'll never be. And she had them all grayed and custom made. And she said it as if that's normal to match your cars to your house. It was awesome.
I don't know. I think
this is a, speaking of other planets, I mean, some people just live a different life.
Yeah, and
you know?
She knows it.
But
it,
yes, a different life financially, so they're on a different level. But I think a lot of people, especially as you get into adulthood, you kind of settle into, like, you kind of wear the same stuff. You and your partner might kind of have the same car. You both got Camrys. I think you kind of have what you like in your home. And I think some people are minimalist, and some people like earth tone things. Other people, you go into your grandmother's house in Key West, she's got palm trees and the little moving hula girl.
You know?
And some people like to have knickknacks in their house. So it's like, it's how you want your house to look. She just has the means to completely, in her mind, make it look in, like that in real life.
Exactly.
Yeah. I think for me, I'm definitely someone who there needs to be character. Like, there has to be different things in the home that you aren't going to walk into everyone's home and see. And that doesn't mean like the entire house, just like little nuances like here and there. But that, I mean, it's beautiful, but I think I would, it would almost have like the opposite effect.
It'd make you crazy.
Yeah, it wouldn't make me calm. It would just be like, where
North,
are
yeah. North has a video where she's making fun of it, being like, our house, you can't touch anything. It's like a museum. It's not fun for like a kid, I bet.
Do you have, you remind me of like a knickknack person.
Tchotchkes? In Yiddish, we say tchotchkes.
Tchotchkes, like garden gnomes. Are you that type of person?
Garden gnomes?
I just feel like
I have several. No, but tchotchkes are really cute stuff that you put on your mantle, but then when it becomes too much, you say, oi, that's ungepatsch. That's too many tchotchkes.
I'm going to use that word for sometimes the conversation goes a little long. Tori, a little ungepatsch down there. All right. Daniel Radcliffe is transforming into Weird Al Yankovic for a new movie. So Weird Al is known, of course, for his music parodies. Here's a look at Daniel as Weird Al. Ooh. There we go. That's Daniel. That's Daniel next to Daniel, and then it's Daniel next to the real Weird Al. What do we think of his transformation?
I don't see it, but I never do until the movie comes out. But it looks like a crappy wig and a weird choice.
But Matt, I think if you throw on the glasses and stuff, I think he might get there.
That's easy to do.
Yeah.
I just didn't picture it. Maybe I'm wrong because I was wrong with Kristen Stewart. I always admit it.
Lucille Ball.
I didn't like, no, I was right about Lucille Ball.
But
she looked terrible.
You just called the whole movie terrible, and it was not.
I watched the whole movie. I didn't like the movie.
You prejudged it.
Yeah, you did. And then you stuck to your guns, and you were wrong.
Excuse me, I thought it was going to be bad, and then it was bad. That's what happened. But I will say, he's just a weird choice because Weird Al's so quirky that I pictured like a weirder, quirkier kind of guy, and then he's British, and I just didn't see it.
Who would you see, like maybe like a Rami Malek? They have kind of the same
face. Yeah, or like a Chalamet, or like kind of a weird.
I'm like a Pete Davidson.
Pete Davidson.
He's kind of goofy.
Maybe. I mean, but I think definitely Timothy Chalamet, who's great in Dune, I think he's got that face, but I don't know. It seems like, Tori, you want them to be the exact same person, not act their way into the role.
No, I think I just want to be able to feel the same energy, and Daniel Radcliffe and Weird Al Yankovic are like two opposites to me. But maybe that's why he's doing it.
We'll see.
Why is everyone like laughing?
Because, I mean, you're not the number one critic. Let's just put it like that.
I see where she's coming from.
I completely forgot what we were talking about.
I never know. Coming up on DBL, our interview with Mary Lou Henner, how she's using her amazing super memory for a one-woman show. And a new documentary about Kanye West is getting a lot of buzz, and we're going to talk about it coming up.
like it, you can't send it back. Just eat it.
Hi, I'm
What's going on, guys? Anyone watching Inventing Anna or Euphoria?
Yes.
I can't watch Euphoria. Are you watching Euphoria?
It's so good.
So good.
Jere is What's back, that? By the way, everyone.
Hi,
y'all
back.
Miss, oh, still
look,
sorry.
This next one is it's more about the broader idea of a documentary or a biopic when the artist themselves is involved. Mm. Do you think it's more effective or not? Or do you think it's just bias and it makes they want to make it like
look
they
as good
make
as they
it.
Want
it?
So let's
and
like around a Kanye rabbit hole.
Okay.
Like
so
you could
yeah,
say creative,
about
but
Kanye
not like,
doc for yeah. there's right. several of them. You could talk about Janet Jackson.
That's
you could talk about.
It's a great note.
Or you can talk about the ones.
Him for 20 years, but he actually publicly anyway stated that he wanted to have final edit approval on the documentary at the last minute.
So we've debated this a lot because yeah. we really like it when they have a thing and I don't.
Yeah, yeah.
So, that's the
so my contrary to that is the okay. Tiger Woods documentary.
That's Tiger Woods.
Yeah. He was not that's involved so and I don't particularly like
a lot of my, my comic friends. Yeah.
Is about a video yeah. that yeah. wasn't allowed and now famous, we're watching a show that wasn't
that
authorized either.
Then we'll go that way.
That's interesting.
Wrong conversation.
Okay, thanks. I think that I am watching Pam and Tommy and if you didn't know, Pamela Ooh. And Tommy don't want this video out. They don't. It was yeah. not authorized by them. And the
That's
ironic thing is, the sex tape was also not authorized by them.
Right.
So we're essentially watching a show that wasn't authorized about a tape that wasn't authorized, and this woman's consent was never given for any of it. And it does make me feel a certain way. Do I watch it still?
Yeah. So then
I put on my makeup with a
problem.
I still
see everything. Because it involves human beings, and we all are.
And they're so good. It was good.
Yeah.
It's a good show. But do I realize that it's incredibly hypocritical when I'm watching it? Yes, I do. Do I still watch it? I do. I still watch it.
It's a weird. I just can't believe, like, with all the things that air quotes leak, whether it's the government, whether it's Jeff knows stuff in sports about, like, oh, the coach is going to get fired next week. Like, what do you mean you leaked? Who said, somebody said that to somebody that printed it. Like,
well,
how
they stole
that,
the videotape.
I know, but from who? Like,
from his safe.
Welcome back to DBL. Kanye West's documentary Genius is out now on Netflix, but the film is raising questions about how much control artists should have in telling their own story. The filmmaker spent 20 years filming the rapper, but in the weeks leading up to its release, Kanye publicly demanded to re-edit the film in order to control his images, and the director obviously refused because the director had final cut. Madonna is also heavily involved in her biopic, from working on the screenplay to also having a say in what actors are involved. But is this a good thing or a bad thing? And should they get involved in their own story, essentially?
This is so funny. We have been watching biopics. We've been watching completely unauthorized, all these things. And now we're concerned that if the person who was actually there has too much say in the story that's being told, it's a problem. They were there.
Yeah.
No, that's their story.
We have all seen, and it's really cool, the things on YouTube where they'll take like a movie like The Karate Kid and make it like cut it so it looks like a horror movie or something. You can take the same footage and make it look like anything.
For sure.
And so if I'm doing the Al Jackson documentary and I have control, I'm going to look like I turned down the NBA for the show. I'm going to make myself look as good as possible because that's what human beings do. Some people are more, forthright about their mistakes and like, hey, I want to talk about the drug abuse or the domestic violence or whatever they're known for, but they're still going to have a redemption story. I think if we want to see things really kind of done in their totality, you have to wait till almost everybody's dead.
Passed
as bad
away.
As that sounds. Yeah, but that's when you're going to get the real story.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
What do you think, Jeff? What were you saying?
Well, I just compared it to the Tiger Woods documentary. That's the latest one, right? I know you were talking about Pam and Tommy, but Tiger Woods had no say in that. He couldn't defend himself on whatever angle they chose to go. I think the most famous, if people don't know what Final Cut means, I think Kris Jenner's like the king of that, right? Mm-hmm. She makes sure her family looks the way they want her
Curated.
To look. Right, and she puts out that final product. If there's something in there that's going to make them look bad, she'll take that out. That's final cut. And now Kanye wants to re-edit the story that the director, that the filmmaker that followed around for 20 years is portraying. So I see both sides. I want to hear that filmmaker side, but I also want Kanye's input if he really doesn't agree with something.
But Kanye's been a part of this since the beginning. He's the person who hired this person, right? I mean, that was the whole idea behind this, which I think you're going to see a lot more of this. I can't remember who the artist was. It was with Biggie and Tupac. There was Biggie had a bunch of cameras following him around. Did you see that one? But I think also we're in an age where there's so much information being put out there about these people on a regular basis. There has to be some format for them to tell their story from their side.
Yeah.
So it's not one-sided. I think it's the two things coming together, and somewhere in the middle lies the truth.
Hmm. Just very quickly, I'll say I'm watching the Pam and Tommy Lee documentary, and it's about a video that was not censored and authorized by her, and now we're watching a show about that, and she has not authorized the entire show. So it does feel a little weird to not have her say on any of the consent on any of it, but it's public. It was a public thing that happened, and you're allowed to make anything about stuff that's public.
That wasn't very quick, but we got your point. We'll be right back with Mary Lou Henner.
Ungapot.
We all know that. American troops are staged in Eastern Europe to assist its allies if Russia attacks Ukraine. President Joe Biden said the U.S. sent equipment into Ukraine and warned it would defend its allies.
And make no mistake, the United States will defend every inch of NATO territory with the full force of American power. An attack against one NATO country is an attack against all of us.
Over the last week, Google search trends showed a spike in people asking about Ukraine's status in the North Atlantic Treaty Organization, or NATO. So, let's verify. Is Ukraine a NATO member? Our sources are NATO, the Brookings Institution, the Embassy of Ukraine to the United Kingdom, and Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky. NATO is an alliance of countries that started after World War II. It started with 12 countries and has expanded to 30 members across North America and Europe, including 5 that share borders with Russia. In order to join, existing members of NATO must unanimously vote in the new country, and the nation must agree to 14 articles. Article 5 is the most frequently referenced because it requires every country to collectively respond to an attack on any NATO member. In 2008, Ukraine applied to join NATO with the support of Presidents George W. Bush and Barack Obama. However, there was resistance from France and Germany, and the application didn't go anywhere. So, no, Ukraine is not a member of NATO, although its application is pending, and it still wants to join the alliance. With your Verify, I'm Brandon Lewis.
I do not tolerate high pressure tactics, so I will give you an answer now. You are not my contractor.
You are making a huge mistake.
Not as big as the mistake you're making. Let go of my arm.
Welcome back. That's Mary Lou Henner in her latest movie, Aurora Teagarden Mysteries, Haunted by Murder. And earlier, we spoke to Mary Lou about her time on Taxi and her amazing memory. Let's take a look.
Mary Lou joins us live. Welcome. Yes. So happy to have you back. Now, during your time on Taxi, you were on the same lot as, let's go through it, Happy Days, Laverne and Shirley, Mork and Mindy. What was that like?
Yeah, Bosom Buddies, Booking Skits, I mean, all these people. It was so incredible to have that. It was kind of like a campus where we were sort of the cool kids, the Taxi kids, because every Friday night after our show, we had a party. And 4 times a year, we'd have a blowout dance party in the Paramount Commissary. So everybody looked to the Taxi kids for their, like, you know,
the cool kids. My gosh, I'd want to go to that party.
Tori just yelled out cool.
Yeah.
She's very envious, very envious of that party.
Yeah.
Very envious. Mary Lou, welcome back.
Thank you. I was going to say, Tom Hanks and Robin Williams and Peter Scolari and Michael Keaton, Jim Belushi, all the Happy Days and Laverne and Shirley.
Now I'm jealous.
Yeah.
Now I'm
out of here. All
right. We had Candace Cameron Bure on the show, and you play her mother. That's right, in Aurora Tea Garden Mysteries, Haunted by Murder. She had a question for you, Mary Lou. I want you to take a look.
Mary Lou, I told you, and I'm sure you remember, my haunted house story. So I want to know if you have any haunted house stories.
Okay, I don't have haunted house stories, but I do have really psychic crazy things that have happened to me. Whoa. I mean, like, unbelievable. Okay, so I'm going to tell you one of my favorites, because I've got probably 50. But this was my favorite. I was with my second husband at the time, Rob Lieberman, and I was doing a movie, so I was night shooting. And I came home, I got into bed, I was tired, and he woke me up at 9 o'clock and he said, "What's Carla's number?" And Carla was somebody who was helping us decorate the house. Carla Champion, brilliant. Anyway, so I rattled off a number. So he calls this number, I hear him talk to this woman, and he says, "Okay, well, when she gets there, please have her call me." So have her call Mary Lou and Rob. So Carla calls back like 10 minutes later and she goes, "Where did you get this number?" And he said, "Well, Mary Lou gave it to me." She said, "How does she have it? Because I don't even have this number you guys called. It's the private line in their bedroom. I'm redoing their bedroom, but no one has this number."
Whoa.
It's a private line. Oh, and he woke me up and said, "Where did you get that number?" I said, "I don't know. You said, give me Carla's number," and I pulled it up. So that kind of thing happened to me. Like crazy hair up the back of your neck kinds of things.
I do have goosebumps. That's and crazy. I will call you later for lotto number. people might know you from Taxi. I know you from Noises Off. I just want to say thank you for that movie because it's my absolute number one favorite. We all know you have an amazing memory, really. Now you're incorporating it into your one woman show and you're performing a song about it. Is it not Memories?
No. I think people would like, some people do this. But my brother wrote this fabulous, you know, the Peggy Lee song, "'Cause I'm a Woman," you know, that song. Mm-hmm. So I thought I have to do a song about my memory because, and let me explain it, you know, it, like in a song. So he wrote these incredible lyrics. Can I sing a little
please,
for you?
Please, please.
Okay, so I'll just do the first verse. So it's like, "I can tell you the day of the week and what I was doing on any given day. I recall every tryst on my list, especially the foreplay. I remember the fall of the big Berlin Wall and what I was eating for lunch. Saddam underground, Koufax on the mount, Muhammad Ali's jungle punch. Cause I had exam, capital H-S-A-M.
Wow.
I'll say it again. Because ASAM is what I have. It's highly superior autobiographical memory.
Okay, so we do have a couple of dates for you. Do you remember what happened on September 13th, 1978?
September 13th. That was the day after. Okay, so September 13th, 1978. That was the day after Taxi premiered.
Whoa.
September 13th was a Wednesday. So it premiered September the 12 on 78 at so it was on then, and then the 2 days later I was actually at the time I was with Johnny Travolta, we were dating then, and we were in London together because he was opening Greece. But on the 15th we went to New Orleans to do the
That was not pre-planned. I give our viewers my word.
No.
Wow. That was completely spontaneous. You are incredible, Mary Lou. Thank you for joining us. Thank you, Mary Lou. Thanks, guys.
Catch Mary Lou in Aurora Tea Garden Mysteries, Haunted by Murder, currently playing on Hallmark Movies and Mysteries. We'll be right back.
Promotional consideration is brought to you by
Lots of people on social media are dropping this tax tip. If you had a baby in 2021, besides not being able to get enough sleep, you'll also be getting a tax break. But before you pop the champagne, let's verify. If you had a baby last year and didn't get extra child tax credit money, can you get it by filing your taxes? We checked the IRS website, spoke with IRS spokesperson Luis Garcia, and asked tax expert Henry Grez. They all agree that yes, you can. Under the American Rescue Plan, parents were given the option to get some of the money that comes in the form of a tax break early and in 6 monthly installments. It also bumped up the credit from $2,000 to $3,000 for kids 6 to 17 and $3,600 for kids under six. The amount of money you got was based on your income and the number of children listed on your 2020 return. So what about new parents? According to our sources, anyone who had a baby, adopted, or fostered a child in 2021 can qualify for the child tax credit as long as you're still under that income limit.
If your income was substantially higher in 2021 than 2020, you potentially are not eligible for as much credit as you would have based on your 2020 return.
And remember, tax season is important for all parents, whether they had a new baby or not. Even those that got the advance payments will need to file for the credit to get the other half of that money. With your Verify, I'm Evan Kozloff.
AARP is now synonymous with the golden years. Its members earn discounts at businesses nationwide. But author Arianna Rebolini tweeted, "There's no age requirement to join AARP," in a post liked 80,000 times. So let's verify. Can anyone join AARP regardless of their age? Our sources are AARP, young adult finance blog Money Under 30, and The Hartford Insurance. AARP makes it clear its mission is to serve older adults by lobbying for their interests in Washington and providing services geared toward seniors. Its 38 million paying members gain access to discounts at restaurants, movie theaters, and other places. Despite once having retired persons in their original name, AARP says anyone can join, even if they're not retired. Money Under 30 points out younger people might benefit from things like a check to see if they're eligible for special student loan repayment and forgiveness programs on top of other perks. However, not every deal is open to everyone. For example, The Hartford Insurance only offers discounts to AARP members who are over 50 years old. So it's true. Anyone can join AARP regardless of their age. And it's not just AARP. Other groups like the Association of Mature American Citizens and the American Seniors Association are also open to people of all ages. With your Verify, I'm Brandon Lewis.
This February, connect with Al, Lindsay, Erica, Jeff, and Tori.
Leveled up.
Spirited talk. Get out of here.
Insane to me. What are we talking about?
Honest emotions.
You are so generous to me. Always entertaining.
I think this is hooey.
And explain to our black viewers what hooey is.
Real conversations are on DBL.
I like that.
Very nice. DBL, all new every day.
Welcome back. Tori, I'm going to put you on the spot at being President's Day. Could you do your president trick where you name them backwards or whatever?
Yeah, well, I'll name them forwards. Should I do it forward?
Yeah, just go.
Okay, Washington, Adams, Jefferson, Madison, Monroe, Quincy, Adams, Jackson, Van Buren, Harrison, Tyler, Polk, Taylor, Fillmore, Pierce, Buchanan, Lincoln, Johnson, Grant, Rutherford, B. Hayes, Garfield, Chester, Arthur, Cleveland, Harrison, Cleveland, William, McKinley, Taft. Am I out?
I think Wilson, that's all of them.